Today I'm going to talk you through the multiple causes and what was the ultimate impact to Italy and Sicily of the Sicilian Vespers. The Sicilian Vespers of 1282 are often misunderstood, and the impacts equally misunderstood. Why did it spread like wildfire across Sicily? And was someone really behind it, as in a conspiracy? How did the offensive behaviour of a drunken French soldier escalate into a war across Europe? To learn more about La Bella Sicilia, consider subscribing. The Vatican was very active commercially, militarily, and politically. There was ongoing tension between the Guelphs, who supported the Pope, and the Ghibellines, who supported the Emperor. The Pope considered his power superseded that of any earthly monarch, even though the Papal States were very much an earthly kingdom. Charles I of Naples, of Anjou, was king of Sicily, and he swore allegiance to the Pope and agreed to make no claim on the papal property in northern Italy and Sicily. These terms were absolutely rejected by the Hohenstaufen dynasty. Charles of Anjou, king of Sicily, was attempting to expand into the Balkans, which would put him in conflict with the interests of Constantinople. And this provoked the Byzantine emperor, Michael VIII, Palaiologos, to seek allies in the Pope, Peter of Aragon, and people in Sicily. Charles was a bad and corrupt leader who soaked the Sicilians in taxes to pay for his ambitions, but ruled a long way away in Naples. This made him a distant, ill-informed ruler with little interest in the good government of Sicily. Of course, the Sicilians hated the French, Charles of Anjou in particular. A number of rich and influential Sicilian families had weathered the comings and goings of numerous foreign invaders. In this period, they were enraged that the Anjou government was filled by French Anjou loyalists with no room for advancement by the upper class Sicilian families. These Sicilian families remained extremely influential across rural Sicily, well beyond the reach of the Anjou government, so it's not surprising that an anti-French sentiment festered across Sicily. Throughout large parts of its history, Italy was actually a loose collection of city-states who often clashed with each other. A group of city-states was left to fight against the national armies of France, Spain, Russia, and Austria. In the case of the Sicilian Vespers, Sicily was far too weak to dislodge Angevin rule, so instead, Peter III of Aragon was approached to liberate Sicily, and in return, the price for his support was that he was to be offered the crown of Sicily. The influential families of the prior ruling classes, the Hohenstaufens, fled to Barcelona, what is in now Spain. Here they lived under the protection of Peter III of Aragon, who was not blind to the strategic impact of Sicily, sat in the middle of the Mediterranean and the Mediterranean trade routes. Peter III even married Constance, the daughter of Manfred, in 1276. Now she was in the former Hohenstaufen dynasty, and he was completely aware that this would give him a claim to Sicily. The Hohenstaufen families living in Barcelona actively lobbied Peter III of Aragon to intervene in Sicily. The viewer should be well aware of the fact that Peter III, in advance of the uprising, had funded a campaign built a fleet and had it moored conveniently nearby on the North African coast. The chickpea is a staple of Sicilian cooking. Its Sicilian pronunciation is chirici, which is difficult to pronounce for French speakers, as they would say chirici. This word was used as a test to check if people were French. Failure to pronounce the word in correct Sicilian pronunciation had ugly and fatal consequences. Byzantine activists stoked Sicilian resentment. The Sicilian Vespers, I Vespri Siciliani, was the uprising of people across Sicily which ended the Anjou misrule. The uprising began on Easter Monday, 30th of March, 1282, at the Church of the Holy Spirit, Palermo. Sicilians were at the church celebrating Easter. A number of different stories circulate based on the behaviour of the troops from the French garrison in Palermo. Scenario 1. A group of French troops arrived and started drinking. A soldier named Drouet was being overfamiliar with a young married woman in the crowd. The woman's husband stabbed and killed Drouet. The remaining French soldiers began to attack the crowd, but were soon overwhelmed and killed. At this point, the church bells rang out for Vespers. Scenario 2. A group of French soldiers were searching the crowd outside the church for weapons, but were using this as a cover to grope the women. Scenario 3. There's a theory that John of Procida planned the uprising with Michael Palaiologos Oligos and Peter III of Aragon. Interestingly, all three were excommunicated by Pope Martin IV that same year. So once the first instance of the Sicilian Vespers occurred, the powerful Sicilian families were able to further destabilize the Anjou government across Sicily. The consequences were the massacre of French men, women and children. Regardless of the scenario, messengers soon spread through Sicily, death to the French, morono gli francesi. Through the night, 2,000 French died, and the uprising now covered Palermo. New leaders were elected in Palermo. Within 6 weeks, Sicily was fully under rebel control, with exception of Messina. This began the War of the Sicilian Vespers. Eventually, rebellion entered Messina, and Charles's fleet burned in the harbour. Under new leadership, the people declared themselves free and loyal only to the Pope, just as were Venice, Genoa and Pisa. The Pope did not accept this. The French Pope stubbornly supported Charles of Anjou. As the Sicilians requested Peter's assistance, his fleet was conveniently moored nearby on the African coast. Peter III arrived in Trapani and his troops moved quickly towards Palermo. As Peter entered Palermo, the population saw him as a foreign occupying king. Peter was crowned at the Cathedral of Palermo. Interestingly, Peter III, Charles I of Anjou and Pope Martin all died soon after 1285. Frederick III spent most of his life fighting against Angevin Naples. The war with the Angevins devastated Sicily, and the Angevins at times attacked and used scorch earth policies on the island. Frederick ultimately failed and made a treaty that on his death, the crown of Sicily would return to the Angevins. One of the consequences of the Sicilian Vespers was the adoption of a Sicilian flag composed of the red for Palermo, yellow for inland Corleone, and the three-legged symbol of Sicily. The Sicilian Vespers inspired an opera by Giuseppe Verdi. The famous poet Dante Alighieri would refer to the bad Angevin government of Sicily in his work The Divine Comedy. The Sicilian Vespers were frequently referred to during attempts to unify Sicily with Italy. Il Risorgimento. Michele Amari wrote about the Sicilian Vespers in the 19th century as a means to inspire a public uprising where Italians would rise up against their foreign Bourbon rulers.